Good morning. So in the previous session we have seen sending SMS using intent service and programmatically how we can send the SMS, as well we have seen how we can send the email using the built-in service, and also we have seen how we can download the binary data using download image method synchronously and both asynchronously. Today we are going to learn how we can download the text file. How we can download the text file. Suppose whatever the page you requested from the client machine, the request which will goes to the server. Based on the request resource by the client, server fetches the information which is resided at the server part and sends back to the client browser. So it is nothing but you are downloading the content of server from server machine to the client machine. So since the mobile is a small device, you cannot download huge amount of data in a local device. So for that, cloud services are there to maintain a files at the cloud. Whenever it is required on demand, you can download and use it. So today's discussion is how we can download the text data. So besides downloading binary data, you can also download plain text content. For example, you might want to access a web service that returns a string of random codes. Suppose your request for the server is Swami Vivekananda quotes. If you search in a Google, it will list out a millions of web pages related to the Vivekananda quotes. Either those quotes in the form of image file like binary data, or it is in the form of the text files. So to download the text files, we need to have the following procedure in the mobile application. So networking text files. The snippet code of the text file download is input stream reader. It's a Java file, input stream reader. You are reading the content from the resource which is downloaded at the client machine. See, string download text is user defined method here, a string URL from which URL you are downloading. The buffer size you set for the 2000 KB at a time you can download. Input stream set to the null in the beginning. And as you aware of that, before downloading anything from the internet, your mobile should be connected with the internet service. That service, which will be defined in the manifest.xml as a permission of internet. So once internet is connected, it is required to open a port for the service for the client request. For that, input stream is defining that you are opening a connection for the URL which you are requested. And if any network issues are there, it will get pushed onto the message to the log.d. So input stream reader, Yes, sir. Input stream means from server to the client. Client machine is that is the input. Output of the server is the input to the client. Output of the client to the input to the server. Right? Input stream reader is used to read the content of that string which you are downloading or requested from the server. You are assigning that to the input buffer. A buffer size maximum you set 2000 bytes. So character, it reads the character by character. If the input stream reader read method is defined here to for the input buffer, you are checking if it is greater than zero, means at least one string should be there. If it is greater than zero, then you are copying the content of input buffer to the read string, input buffer to the read string, and you are appending all the content of the buffer string to a read string object. Then input buffer equal to new character buffer size. So here this statement is repeated here. Previously it was set to the 2000 bytes. Now you are setting the new size according to the content of the downloading of the text. Based on that, new buffer is going to be allocated for that. And after opening the connection, you require to close it. So if any exception arises in between, that will be handled in the IO exception. And this private class download text task extends asynchronous task. It is an handler. Async task is an handler class here. It will handle the if you are downloading the multiple string from the different URLs. After this, you are downloading the string content from the single site, because here single site URL you mentioned. So if you want to download from the multiple sites, you are required to extend this download text task to the asynchronous task, the string and the string warden string. So protected string do in background. So suppose if you are requesting for the multiple sites of the same content or different content, most of the things processing is happening at the background. So while downloading, return download text. Every time when you request for the URL, that URL which will be assigned to be called to the download text, actually what we think feel that we are downloading multiple files at a time, but what actually at the background how it happens, the child thread spawns every time when the new request goes to the server. So the child thread will continue to download the content of a file you requested. So if multiple times you requesting means multiple threads it will spawn, and every thread which will run in a background to complete the task which you have given. Here task is in downloading the text file. Then protected void on post execute. It is required to execute on post. On post, what it is going to do is it is going to display the string which is downloaded from the server. Once it is downloaded and put it in a cache memory, that is buffer memory of the client machine, now that you are required to fetch the buffer content and assigning to the string, that string object is going to be showcased through the alert and notification. Here the alert which you used is the notification is used is toast, make test, base context, current context, result is going to be displayed onto a activity. Here suppose if you are downloading a text, how you require to do this is new new download text task dot execute method is used. In the execution, you are providing the URL string. This, when you execute, call the execute method by passing the URL string, automatically what it will call, it will call this on post execute. When it will call here, new download text task dot execute, this URL is requesting to the server in turn returns the code values onto a download text task. If only here in our case it's a single URL request, so it will comes to here and it will start calling the download text. What is the download text we defined here? The download text is this, what the string URL you passed. So one at a time message it will fetches and assigning it to the string buffer, and it is going to fetch and display. See how much we are easily requesting the server many a times just by single click. But what is the actual process behind the scene is happening? See, these are all the processes involved, because it requires the necessary memory in local machine. Also it requires to calculate the size of the file it is going to fetch from the server. All those things which is happen behind the scene. Clear? Next, assessing web services. The previous section showed how to download some plain text from a server. Now, more frequently, not just we are downloading the text file or the image files or binary data. In addition to that, many a times we are expected to download the XML content. Usually the web services are defined. So you need to download XML files and parse the contents. A good example of this is consuming web services. Consuming web services is the concept of downloading the XML files and parse the content according to the parsing rules which you defined. It is going to be display onto the client machine. So most cases consuming web services which will make use of HTTP GET request method, usually to fetch the content from the existing server, and the existing server content usually we are going to use the GET request method, HTTP GET request method. Once the web service returns the result in XML, you require to extract the relevant parts and display its content using the Toast class. See, for example, if you are considering the Hero Honda See, here is an example of obtaining the web service request and the HTTP header content, how it look like, and how the XML page is going to be parsed, and the meaning of the word which you have sent in the URL string, how you are going to fetch that snippet code is discussed here. See, HTTP header which will have the following format: GET request. Usually, to obtain a web services, usually we will request with a GET HTTP request type is used. The URL of the website is up to the define, and it is a delimiter. The requested word meaning is string type, and the protocol which it is going to use is 1.1 version, HTTP and 1.1 version. The host is from where you are going to fetch the content of this word equal to string, the services.anovera.com. So the prototype type and status is okay, means this web service is up and running. You can request for the request to the service for the services.anovera.com. The content type you requested is either the text or XML format. Characters set standard which used is UTF-8. The length of the content is requested for the entire length of that definition of that word you requested. So once request goes to the web service, it will return the response in the following format, that it will the return of the response in the form of XML. So in the XML word definition you are defining defined under this host anovera.com, under that web services, in the web services all the resources relevant to the definition of the word you requested to the server. So the word you requested is, in this example, it is a string. It is the string. So definitions related to this string definition, several definitions are found. Definition, first definition, the string, a dictionary. In the dictionary, string, name of the string is string. Means that, suppose if you request for define, here word is defined. Definition is defined, dictionary is defined, and name of that word is also defined. Some definition you are providing for this string here, etc. And so in this format, it is going to be fetch and post back to the as a response to the client. To work with XML, you need to establish an HTTP connection to the web method and then pass the XML result that is returned. So always you need to be establish an internet connection. Second one is open the HTTP connection. Similarly, close the HTTP. These three actions you need to be performed whenever you are requesting for the web services or downloading the binary data like images or the audio or video files and the XML text file, as well as downloading the text data. Like this, you can obtain the content in the form of XML file. Right? So the downloaded content will look like this. Definition of Apple, Apple definition, Apple words, relevant definition you are going to found, and fetches and parses this one. According to that parse result, the resultant output is going to be displayed onto your mobile screen through the activity. So now after obtaining the XML from the server and returned as a string of XML, now how we are going to fetch the XML document using the Java code as below. See, use the same project what we have created, like this is the request what we made through GET, and this is the response what we obtained from the server. And to fetch the content, you need to pass the XML. To passing the XML document, the following snippet code is used to pass the document. To passing the document, we need the following packages: javax.xml, .parsers.documentbuilder, and builder factory is required, and parser configuration except since while passing there is a possibility of exception, you need to handle that. For that you need to have a parser configuration exception. String word definition, this method will be called. As usual, you are reading the connection, inputting, opening the HTTP connection, and reading the string of HTTP what we have seen in the previous example. And in addition to that, you are creating the doc object, builder factory object, and you are creating the new instance of that builder factory object, and builder document builder is DB. So DB equal to a build factory inbuilt instance you are using, new document builder, you are building a new document. See, the content is in the form of XML. That is the reason you are making use of builder factory. What this factory is going to do is, it is going to create the new document format, and you are pushing the content of the definition of the word you requested to the server. So pushing the content onto the DB document builder, you need to be parsed. So parsing happens here using DB. Here DB is the document builder, documentbuilder.parse of input stream reader. If any exception, you need to handle that using parser configuration exception. If no exception found, then you are going to obtain doc is nothing but a document dot get document element dot normalize. So it is going to set, it is going to create the new document which will have the content, parsed content which was fetched from the XML web services. Retrieve all the definition elements, that is to retrieve the all definition elements. You need to define node list definition elements equal to doc dot get elements by tag name. This is a which type of the tag, this one, get elements by tag name. It is a JavaScript code, right? Through the JavaScript code, you are fetching the definition tag elements, all the definition tag elements. How many are there? You just go through this this one. So one definition, then second definition, then two definitions are found. So it is going to fetch the definition element. After fetching all the definition elements, now you require to go iterate through each definition elements using the looping construct. So first you are finding the length of the number of definition elements found. In our case, it is two elements, two document definitions we found. From that definition documents, again you are fetching item node. So look into the item node here. Item node is here word string. So item node you are fetching. Node item node equal to definition elements dot item. The definition which found inside that definitions tag, you are retrieving each one of the definition which it is defined under the web service and assigning that as a item node. Suppose if item node get node type equal to element node, node dot element, element node, if it is equal to that, then definition is going to be fetched here using definition element equal to item node. You are retrieving the information from that element node. So now get all the word definition elements under the definition element. You need to define node list word definition elements. All the elements begin with the word is going to be listed here. It repeatedly, recursively, it happens till it reaches all the elements and sub elements of the XML content, and going to be fetch the content from each of the sub nodes and assign as a word definition element. Finally, that is going to be generate a new document which consists of the information of that XML which you requested for the service. Okay, in this way you are going to fetch the node value of the text which you requested for the string definition. And there is a possibility of IO exception. If any exception is thrown in XML parser, obviously there is a possibility of input output exception you need to handle. Okay, so finally it returns the string definition or definition of that string which you passed for its meaning. So finally that is going to be pushed onto the class access web service task extends asynchronous task handler is defining in the same way. The if you are passing the multiple requests, this string URLs is used. What we have discussed in the previous example, how to pass the HTTP URL to the access web services and downloading the text file. In the same way, you are passing all the strings here and pushing onto the word definition, right? Finally, that is going to be displayed as an output to the user. Here, the call happens here in the base class. Once the activity is loading, during that loading of the activity, you called the new access web services task.execute Apple. So you are finding the definition for the Apple. This Apple is going to be called access web service task. Access web service task is defined here. What service you are expecting? The Apple definition of Apple. So this Apple URL which will fetch here, and it will call word definition URLs. This word definition URLs is defined here in this code, in this word definition. What word you passed? Apple. So internally it will fetches and passes the XML content node by node, and till it reaches the element value. Once you are obtaining the element value, it is going to push that content onto a toast notification. through the toast you are pushing onto a activity of the phone. So internally it is very easy to click and obtain the information from the services and the server, but in reality lots of process is involved behind the scene which is not visible to the end user. That's the power of internet and the web services. Clear? Fine. So we'll discuss consuming JSON services in the coming session. Today now we're going to have a small activity discussion with relevant to the case study and innovation. Okay, we'll go with this consuming JSON services in the next session. Any questions are there in the today's topic are relevant to the internals? Okay, all of you note down. Create, design. All of you note down. Design and develop an app which provide the best services to the train passenger. So now do this activity. Case,
can you repeat, sir, question?
Yes.
Can you repeat the question, sir?
I'll repeat. Case study is similar to this type of the question. Internal test 2 is more on code based rather than definition based test. So practice the coding, especially the unit 3, practice design and coding content will be there more on the rather than the definition. The coding will be there. You design, you practice the coding, which it is discussed in the PPT as well as in your textbook. Refer the textbook, prepare, come with well preparation for the test. It's interesting, and also it will take a time to write also. So that's why you practice the coding part. Similar to these kind of the thing, what I am given here the question. So design and develop an app which provide the best services to the train passenger. So you do designing and share one of you share the screen and start scribbling. Do designing. So development is it is difficult to write the entire code of the thing in within a one and a half hour. So it is limited to that. You require to provide the snippet code is enough. Okay, so main concept should be covered there, but snippet code is enough. Getting? So design and develop an app which provide the best services to the train passenger. First, identify the requirement of train passenger. What train passenger is expected? It is actually, it's a broad question. Yes or no? Broad question. From where it start? From his source of begin to the destination point. What the train is providing the service to the passenger. On board service is different. Off board service is different. Waiting room. So many things, kind of services are there for the train passenger. It is an open-ended question for you. You think which is the best service you can provide. apart from the existing service. Now existing services are there already in the train, right? So now apart from that, what tells the passenger? It helps the passenger. Okay, try to add the two features. Try to add new two features to the existing service. This will be the assignment question also, and also it help you to write the similar or similar to this kind of questions in internals also. Okay, if you practice this, obviously you will score a good in internal test too. Fine. Also, it's an assignment. Assignment 3. What is assignment 2? Do you remember? Assignment 2. Clear? The internal test portion is module 2 half portion, means remaining of the first internal, and the module 3 full portion. So focused on coding, design and coding. Course outcomes 1, 2 and 4. Focused on 1, 2 and 4 of the course outcomes, design and coding. Prepare. Okay, any questions are there? The case study is MIT Inventor app 2. Explore the MIT Inventor app. What for Inventor app? What was the operating system or the languages or the software used to build this MIT? Such stuffs you just go through, not only just the how to make use of the build tools, etc. and so on in the MIT. Apart from that, even go and explore the general content and specific content of that MIT app. Clear? MIT Inventor App 2. Inventor 2 app. Innovative, similar to the assignment 3 question. Let me know if any doubts are there. So unique answers are expected for the innovative case study. Might be a same or different. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Thank you.